What's the matter with you? Yes, I have traveled back and forth in time 4 times 20 years. How did you get it? I was part of a secret program. So now we have to talk about that. Hello and welcome to another episode of Matrixer TV with Jonathan and Shiva.
Jonathan und Shiva.
Yes, we got together today to talk about an important, interesting topic. And I can assure you, it's getting pretty crazy. It's about the secret space program. Exactly. Perhaps one or the other has already heard of you. This is a program from the fantasy series. No, unfortunately not the secret space program. Children are recruited by a secret space program, so to speak. These children are trained to be soldiers and sent to war against other aliens. We were there too. And that's why we tell you about it. We don't know all of this in its entirety, but enough to tell you about it and so that you can perhaps get an idea for yourself and deal with it. Yes, of course, through the practice of dissociation, hypnagogic states, astral travel and the like, we have received such information that we appear to have been part of this secret space program. You can also find references in John Leonard Watson. This is just an astronomer who has been using telescopes for a while. And he was never really satisfied with these telescopes and thought I'd make my own. And he made his own telescope with his own eyepieces, etc. Lenses and after that he really kept looking out into space with his telescope and discovered spaceships in orbit around the Earth. Interestingly, he explained that when using standard commercially available eyepieces, he could not see these spacecraft. Only he could discover these spaceships with his own tinkered eyepiece. And I find that very interesting, don't you? He also made videos about it, which means you can see them. Yes, you can see these spaceships. Check out his channel on YouTube. He also makes lunar videos and also shows other planets from our solar system. And very interesting conclusions, very interesting things to see where you really can only open mouth. We recommend. In any case, this is actually a hint for us in the outer world that perhaps we weren't so wrong. Because we know what we perceive in dissociation as real for us, is the truth for us. And dissociation has the ability to see through all camouflage, through all obfuscation, through all manipulation and the like. And that's why it's so important for us to practice it. What we just found out from our research is that we were both part of the space program. And we found some clues about it. So the secret space program is about recruiting people for the war against aliens and they pick you up when you're 5 years old and take you to their spaceship to another planet. Sometimes Mars. The is often mentioned in this context. And there you are trained for about 10 years, trained for 5 to 10 years and then sent to war. And the average length of service is 20 years. And after those 20 years of being in some kind of clone body, you're then sent back, 20 years in time, and dumped again, with amnesia of course, at the point where you were picked up. Exactly. So it works like this. A clone is created from your body. A physical image and a part or a large part of your consciousness is transferred from this very body into the clone body. And that's when you get trained. And trained doesn't just mean you fight with weapons. You also have more skills there than you have here. Oh yeah, so PSI skills are also taught. For example, telekinetic defense. That is, you really learn to hurl people or beings away with the power of your mind. Or telepathic powers and the like are used and taught there so that you can survive in the fight against other extraterrestrial forces. Exactly. And sometimes it doesn't just happen once that you get a clone body, but several times. We were both in the program several times. I think I was ordered there 4 times and you 3 or 4 times 2. And that means that, at the bottom of our hearts, we are not as old as we are, but about 80 times 80 years older. Yes, yes, Shiva, tell us what clues you have that you have been part of this secret space program. Exactly. So between the ages of 4 and 8, back then in the GDR, sad as it is, there was no television and no radio. So at the age of 4, I knew I was kidnapped. And I always had this behind my right ear. I always had this. I got the impression that they were probes that someone had implanted in me. Which 4-year-old child comes up with the idea, if there can't be any external influences, through television, radio, although they wouldn't mention something like that on the radio anyway, comes up with the idea of being kidnapped, with implants and probes behind their ears. And that's a pretty good indication that there's something to it. Because yes, it's amazing. So at the age of 4 or 5 without knowing anything about it, and that in a row. Yes, well, I noticed that about 4 times. That's about the 4 times I found out. So 4 years in a row. I always had this feeling at the same time. I was being kidnapped and I had these probes behind my ear. So when you were 4 or 5, you had the feeling that probes were behind your ear. Why did you name the probes? I don't know. I was a child. I mean, what do you? How did you define for yourself as a child what a probe actually is? I don't think I called it a probe. All I knew was that something was being done from outside, by some aliens, or I don't know what was coming in, or I was kidnapped. That was my explanation. So maybe some kind of. I thought, exactly. I always thought it was a transmitter so I could be located. Ah, okay. So that you can be found again. Ah, yes. Okay, yes, then the probe is quite appropriate. And of course, in the GDR, there was not a lot of radio and television. And even if that had happened, they certainly wouldn't have said things like that. And my parents weren't open to anything like that either. Yes, so I think that's an indicator. So that at least you were visited by aliens or maybe even by people who are part of the secret space program. And people are working there with other aliens on the secret space program, just to take action against other aliens. Exactly. Often these are territorial defenses, I suppose. But I think there can also be economic reasons why this is done. And, yes, we've known since the hacker Gary McKinnon, who somehow hacked over 90 NASA computers and found Excel spreadsheets on them. And these Excel spreadsheets were lists. Lists of alien spaceship pilots. And nobody believed him back then. But at some point he was caught and NASA wasn't at his door, it was the military.
Da stand nicht die NASA bei ihm vor der Tür.
Because NASA is actually presented as a private organization. But actually that doesn't correspond to reality. There is somehow a special group of the military behind it, which manages and instructs NASA, so to speak. That's why military soldiers suddenly stood in front of Gary McKinnon's door and then cashed him in. And then he was put in custody. And then they asked the English government, because Gary McKinnon was English, and they wanted him to get a year in prison for every computer he hacked. Oh, for God's sake, yes, so that means he should go to prison for 90 years for just hacking into NASA computers. It was back and forth for years as to whether he would be extradited to America. Do you all know from Julian Assange, who somehow got into problems like that? And yes, you can see that there too. And what I find interesting is what he discovered. These Excel spreadsheets of extraterrestrial spaceship pilots. He said he even saw trade routes there. So he assumed that they were merchant ships. So there is a secret space program, which ensures that this trade can continue to take place with other planets, most likely other matrix planets, you might say. And there are already quite a few whistleblowers on the internet who suddenly remember that they were part of this secret space program. Exactly, and you don't just train to be a soldier. What we found out is that you are then also trained to become a diplomat. Yes. For diplomatic negotiations between different races, etc. That's exactly what we forgot to mention. Yes, of course. I think you get trained for different things there. Maybe to telepaths. Having a telepath sitting next to you during negotiations is very handy. Because you can use telepathy to assess exactly whether there is something wrong with the other person, right? And whether the negotiating partner really has good intentions. Yes, you said you were kidnapped more often when you were 4, 5. Let's assume that this was now part of the secret space program. Then you must have been kidnapped. Then your spirit was put into a clone body and then you were trained there for a certain function. Warrior, telepath, psychokinet, I think, are the three standard programs that run there. So supposedly I was a diplomat. Right, or diplomat for trade, i.e. for trade negotiations with other aliens. Yeah, right, and when I look at myself now, for example, as a child I didn't have the feeling that I had been kidnapped. No, but I know you once told me about a dream and it's very, very funny. Yeah, so some dreams I had there. I've looked through my logs, i.e. my dream logs, which may be related to the secret space program, and I found some strange dreams indeed. We're all excited. Yes, a dream. You can also do it in my blog at matrixblogger.de. Read. The article was called Kidnapped in Walt Disney Pajamas. Yeah, right. And I was dreaming. I was 5 years old and I always wore a Walt Disney suit, pajamas, the kind you give to small children. I wore pajamas like that. And I still remember that I woke up in the morning. I dreamed it all. That I woke up in the morning because I heard my parents talking. And then I went to the window and looked down and somehow saw my parents working wildly down there. And there were several military soldiers in front of the door. I could look down at the gate from up there. Well, they were standing at the garden gate, so I could watch it well from the window, and suddenly one of these military soldiers pulled out a pistol and shot my parents. Simply, and then of course I panicked. And then they came up to me and took me with them. Doesn't necessarily mean I was in the secret space program. But I discovered other dreams too. Dreams in which, for example, I was sitting in a bar, in some kind of restaurant, and I was wearing a military uniform. And two tables away sat a general. So that was the leader, so to speak, the leader of our military base. And I heard him talking about Stargate. And he said, these Stargates have to run so that we can go over to other planets and trade and talk to them. And I found that so interesting, the Stargates thing, that I was always trying to get at the general somehow. But I didn't have the rank now to be able to address him so directly. And I just hoped that maybe right now I was there in this inn, pub or canteen or whatever that was. I just hoped to meet the general by chance, so that I could finally enjoy seeing such a Stargate. And these are such individual dreams that may indicate this. I also had another dream. In it, for example, I also saw a military base where I was and we all got bracelets there. And after we got these bracelets, we then had to go into a big room. End of the room, it was said that these are all people who are just being taken up to the spaceship and from there to an extraterrestrial planet. So to another planet. So then be taken to another planet. And I remember that I also met a woman there who I talked to, and we sat there and got something to eat beforehand. And then we should get ready to be transferred to the spaceship. So all such small sequences that I personally could never really explain. I remember a dream. Okay. I was picked up there by a spaceship commando. And they picked me up for a mission. Aha. Yes. Exact, yes. So, these are all indications to us that we were also part of this secret space program. And we have something else. We were both on Mars. And we have there. I have or you saw it as a dream exactly right. I just saw it as a flash that there were wars. But we both know that we haven't been here on this Earth long enough to have witnessed the Mars wars. The yes, about 75,000 years must have been, about. Yes. But we haven't been here that long. So it must have been something else. And we also strongly suspect that this Mars mission was part of the secret space program with us. That's right. I wanted to talk about that too, including all the memories I found about Mars. Exactly. For example, one memory was that I had been classified as a security guard. That is, I had been assigned. And while I was on my way to relieve my guard because I had had a break, I was on my way to a bunker and was supposed to relieve the guard there. And then suddenly I saw umpteen spaceships in the sky, all of which were fighting. And I interpreted it back then, it's been a long time since I dreamed or experienced it, that it could have something to do with the Mars wars that happened 75,000 years ago years, as you say. But Shiva said that correctly, we didn't even live here on Earth. We also found out in dissociative states that we weren't even there yet. Yes, we incarnated here on Earth later. So we can have participated there. So the experience I had there must have happened later. And so that could point to the secret space program. Another experience I have. I remember that I was in a kind of big square where they had set up a stage, and I was on Mars. A stage had been set up and the general was supposed to come straight away and somehow give a speech about how to proceed, the mission, etc. And downstairs they set up chairs everywhere and then we were probably sitting there with 100 people. We have so, then waited until the general comes. And I used to think when I experienced that, where does that fit in? In which reality, in which alternative reality does this dream experience fit? And then it only became clear much, much later that these were probably memories that had been erased from a separate reality, that they must have belonged to it. So that means, we don't only dream of alternative realities at night, but also of erased memories, which are still flying around in fragments somewhere in the subconscious and then sometimes come to the surface in the dreams. And, yes, when you have completed your program, your 20 years, you will be sent back. And I always found what you said very exciting. These aren't my real parents. Yes. Of course you won't get back into exactly this reality. Correct. So you have to consider that after you have completed these 20 years of service, you will be sent back 20 years with your consciousness and released again exactly at the position where you were kidnapped at the time. And that also explains to me why the military soldiers simply shot my parents. It was irrelevant. No, because if they send me back in time, my parents will be alive again. And that's exactly why it didn't really matter to shoot the parents. In quotation marks, it didn't matter. Because in the end, it will somehow not necessarily be reality for me that my parents are dead. Yes, so that's it. You have to think a bit outside the box with the whole story. Round trips give headaches. Yes, yes, quite. And yes, and that's just the point we're trying to make. Because I've always wondered about some dreams that I couldn't place. I was able to classify most of the dreams into certain alternative realities. Ah, that's reality 17. Let's say that's reality 20. That's reality, reality 26. I could always sort it all out. But I couldn't really classify these dreams and I assumed that they could possibly be memories. Where should they come from? Where should they come from? And the space program is of course a, how should I put it, a very, yes, optimal explanation for these dreams that I had. And also for your experiences, where you remembered at the age of 4 that you had been kidnapped there. Although, you didn't know anything about aliens or somehow had any idea about them. Yes, dear ones, it is an exciting time. We just wanted to have it cut, although that's probably another 30 minutes. And so that you can deal with the fact that there is more happening here in our world than meets the eye. Often, yes, however. So we saw other things as well. But they are not part of the secret space program. But we'll talk about that in the next videos. Yes, this will also be a very creepy, super exciting video. And yes, we won't reveal too much. No, we won't reveal that much. No, that will come later. And yes, that's the secret space program. We would be very happy if you might have any experiences or memories that you cannot classify and that are perhaps similar to our memory in terms of pattern. You can research your consciousness and your memories that are left to you. And then write in the comments below. Would please us. Yes, maybe we can put some more pieces of the puzzle together and maybe find out more about the secret space program than we've been able to do so far. Because it's a secret space program. A secret space program. And uncovering secrets is always a little more difficult. But we're on the way. And maybe you have memories that show a similar pattern. Exactly. Of course, we have already watched some videos from these whistleblowers, etc. And we collect puzzle pieces. Yes, so if you feel like it, you are welcome to add your puzzle pieces below. Yes, we are happy that you were there again at the Matrixers and listened to our explanations. Yes, it was really nice that you were there and we are very happy. See you next time. See you next time. Dot. Take care. Ciao.
Aufs nächste Mal. Macht's gut. Ciao.